Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are testing the Terrapin, the turtle. Well, I still don't like how the front engines are angled. This wouldn't make much sense. And we are starting with one Swan missile. Shields front side 86, stern at maximum. One size 2 missile. Shields front side 80, stern at maximum. A lot of the ship was flashing. Yes, I could scan, but this would take too much time if I would scan after each single hit. I guess the reason why so many things were flashing is the Terrapin has terrible shield holes around the front engines and this radar dome. One size 3 missile. Shields front side 77, stern at maximum, and still no visible damage on the hut. One size 5 torpedo. Shields all around at 63. Two size 5 torpedoes. Shields all around at 28. We are in a damaged state with sparks and smoke. Center is orange because we have a big shield hole at this radar dome. We have our guns. Normal SM speed, afterburner. And this is sluggish. Yeah, she is sluggish now. Poor little thing. And here's a damaged state with warning lights, smoke and sparks. This looks dangerous. One size 9 torpedo. The two memes explain why I do this, and I use missiles and torpedoes as my yardsticks. Terrapin is done in 3.8. So for now, in my tests with high alpha damage and ships in standard loadout, the Terrapin is tougher than a Cutlass Black, not as tough as the Andromeda. However, if I want to, I can make the Cutlass Black as tough as the Terrapin. I just have to change the shields. Let's take a look at the patch comparison. I have data of the Terrapin from 3.1 to today, and between 3.7 and 3.8 nothing changed in regards to missile, torpedo, gun damage or shield HPs, so those numbers are identical. Would I go into battle in a Terrapin in 3.8? Or let's rephrase this, would I use a Terrapin? Well, the Terrapin has a very specific job. She is a scout and she has to look for targets, for enemies. And we don't have this gameplay in game yet, so there is no reason to use a Terrapin right now. If you want to and you have a Terrapin, you can do cargo deliveries and maybe some lower level bounty hunting, but she isn't a good fighter, which is fine, it's not her role. Like many other ships, the Terrapin has a lot of terrible shield holes, especially around the front engines and the radar dome. Look at my video. Like most other ships, maybe all, the Terrapin has terrible shield holes. You can shoot off the front engines very easily. I'm using two size 1 laser repeaters here, energy guns, and energy guns are not bypassing shields. Yeah, the front left engine is gone already. Let's go to the other side. Well, I noticed in my test for a long, long time that the front engines are getting damaged very easily in my missile and torpedo tests. And now I know why. Front engine is already red and gone. And there's a big shield hole around the radar dome. Here I'm looking for the right spot. And I found it. You can see that the center is flashing. With shields still very close to max, now center is orange, red, and we destroyed the Terrapin, which should not be possible because we didn't even scratch the shields. And I really wish the people who are making the decisions at CIG would have some basic understanding of physics and engineering. As it stands right now, a lot of ships in Star Citizen wouldn't work in space because the main engines are just in the wrong spot. The vector of thrust has to be aligned with the center of mass. It's not a good idea to have main engines angled because you are wasting fuel, and main engines should have gimbaled nozzles, or the whole main engine should be gimbaled. And as it stands right now, less than 10% of the ships in Star Citizen are following this rule, which is basic. Maybe someone by Chris Kerbal Space Program, so that he learns where to put the engines. I won't give a rating for the Terrapin in 3.8 because we still don't know how well scouting will work. As always, you can find the link to my spreadsheet, to my Locus wonderful data and a lot more useful guides in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video and see you next time. Bye, auf Wiedersehen. Hey, you are still here. You might want to join me on Twitter. My Twitter account is Kameral_FFM, and this is the city I live in, Frankfurt am Main. On Twitter I post about my videos and sometimes just some funny little videos. Action! Would be nice if you would join me on Twitter. I decided to put this at the end of my toughness test videos from now on. If you already know this, then just skip it. So how tough is your ship? There are different factors, and I start with the hard factors. How many shield hit points does the shield generator provide? What armor does the ship have? Right now, all ships only have some generic armor values. And how many hit points do different parts of your ship have? Then we have soft factors. How big is your ship? How many shield faces are hit by an attack? And how easily are certain parts of your ship getting destroyed? For instance, some ships are prone to losing wing guns or wings. And then we have bugs. Right now we have a bug that the shields don't cover the whole shape of the ship, especially when the shape is elongated.